Saraswate Deve Gauravani Kartacharine Nirvisesha Sunyavadi Padachadi Satarine Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadha Sri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadha Sri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadha Sri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Hare Hare, Jai Radha, Jama Sundara, Radha, Jama Sundara. Hare Hare, Jai Radha, Jama Sundara, Radha, Jama Sundara. Jai Krishna Balaram, Jai Krishna Balaram, Jai Krishna Balaram, Jai Krishna Balaram. Jai Jagannatha, Jai Jagannatha, Jai Baladeva, Jai Subhadra. Jagannatha Swami Nayana Patagami, Nayana Patagami Bhavatume. Jagannatha Swami Nayana Patagami, Nayana Patagami Bhavatume. Jai Gauranita, Jai Gauranita, Jai Gauranita, Jai Gauranita. Nitai Gaur Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. Nitai Gaur Hari Bol. Jai Sachinandana, Jai Sachinandana, Jai Sachinandana. Gaura Hari, Gaura 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 Hari, Gaura 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 Hari. Nitai Gaur Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. Nitai Gaur Hari Bol. Nitai Gaurangro, Nitai Gaurangro, Nitai Gaurangro, Jai Gaura Hari. Nitai Gaurangro, Nitai Gaurangro, Nitai Gaurangro, Jai Gaura Hari. Gaura 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 Hari. Nitai Gaur Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. Nitai Gaur Hari Bol. Nadiya Bihari Gaura Hari, Nadiya Bihari Gaura Hari. Gaura 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 Hari, Gaura 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 Hari. Nitai Gaur Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. Nitai Gaur Hari Bol. Jai Prabhu Pada, Jai Prabhu Pada, Jai Prabhu Pada, Jai Prabhu Pada. Jai Jai Prabhupad, Prabhupad, Prabhupad. Jai Jai Prabhupad. Jai Gaurvandi, Hari Hari Bol. Jai Om Vishnu Pad, Paramahansa Parivrajakacharya. अष्टोत्तर शतश्री श्रीमद इज्रिवंगे से श्री भक्ति वेदांत संशुपाद की जाए। देव ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिराज काचार्य अष्टोत्तर शतश्री श्रीमद इज्रिवंगे श्री भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वत गुरु गोस्वामी प्रभुपाद की जाए। आनंद गौड़ी वैष्णवंद की जाए। नमाचार्य श्रीदास ठाकुर की जय। प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधार श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवंद की जय। श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गोप गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरी गोवर्धन की जय। ब्रजभूमि श्री वृंदावन धाम की जय, नवद्वीप मायापुर धाम की जय, श्री क्षेत्र जगन्नाथ पुरी धाम की जय, गंगमयी वनमयी की जय, भक्ति देवी तुलसी महाराण की जय, समवेत भक्त वृंद की जय, हरिनाम संकीर्तन की जय, ताय गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि गो आलोरीष्ट वसंगली ओडि हरे कृष्ण, आलोरीष्ट वसंगली ओडि हरे कृष्ण, ఆల్లోరీష్ట వసంపల్లి ఓడి జరే కృష్ణ, ఆల్లోరీస్ 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 శ్రీ శ్రీ గురువు అండ్ శ్రీ గౌరాంగ శుభపాదకి జయ. ఓం విష్ణుపదాయ కృష్ణపిష్టాయ భూతలే శ్రీమతే భక్తి వేదాంత స్వామిని నామిని నమస్తే సారస్వత దేవే గౌరవాణి ప్రచారణే నిర్విశేష శూన్యవాద పాశ్చాత్యదేస్తాయ శుభపాదకి జయ. नमस्ते नरसिंहाया, नमस्ते नरसिंहाया, प्रहलाद लाद दाईने, प्रहलाद लाद दाईने, हिरण्यकशिप वक्षः శిలతంకానకాలయే, శిలతంకానకాలయే, ఇతో నసిమా పరతో నసిమా, ఇతో నసిమా పరతో నసిమా, యతో యతో యామి తతో నసిమా, యతో యతో యామి తతో నసిమా, వాయే నసిమా నరసింహమదీం చరణాం ప్రపదే, నరసింహమదీం చరణాం ప్రపదే, తవ కర కమల మరేనాకా అద్భుత శృంగారం దళిత హిరణ్యకశిపో తన భృంగ తీరా వనచారి, జరా Yamuna Tira Manachari Radha Madhava Puja Vihari Gopi Jana Vallava Giri Varadari Sodanandana Vraja Jana Ranjana Yamuna Tira Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Radha Shyama Sundara Radha Shyama Sundara Chapter 1, title Observing the Armies, verse number 39, we left at 40, but we'll start from 39, we'll finish the chapter today, hopefully. 46 is the last verse, so 1.39. ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत् नष्टाप्रयेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवतसेवया भगवती उत्तमश्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी हरिः ओं तत्सत् Okay, 1.39. Kulakshaye pranasyanti kula dharma sanatana Dharmo nashte kulam krishnam adharmo abhi bhavati uta Kulakshaye pranasyanti kula dharma sanatana Dharme nashte kulam krishnam adharmo abhi bhavati uta Kulakshaye pranasyanti kula dharma sanatana Dharme nashte kulam krishnam adharmo abhi bhavati uta Word to word translation Kulakshaye in destroying the family Pranasyanti become vanquished Kula dharma the family traditions Sanatana eternal Dharme religion nashte being destroyed Kulam family krishnam whole adharma Irreligion, Abhibhavati, transforms, Uta, it is said. Translation by Jivangaya Sesi Bhakti Vedanta Samshukopasya Gopala Ki Jaya. With the destruction of the dynasty, the eternal family tradition is vanquished. And thus, the rest of the family becomes involved in irreligion. Let's repeat. With the destruction of the dynasty, the eternal family tradition is vanquished. And thus the rest of the family becomes involved in irreligion. Verse number 40. Adharma vibhavat Krishna pradashyanti kulastriyaha strishu dushtasu varsneya jayate vanna sankaraha. Adharma vibhava Krishna pradashyanti kulastriyaha strishu dushtasu varsneya jayate vanna sankaraha. Adharma vibhavat Krishna pradashyanti kulastriyaha strishu dushtasu varsneya jayate vanna sankaraha. Whatever translation, adharma, irreligion, abhibhavat, having become predominant, Krishna, O Krishna, pradushyanti, become polluted, kulastriyaha, family ladies, strishu, by the womanhood, dushtasu, being so polluted, varsneya, O descendant of Vrushni, jayate, comes into being, Varna Sankara, unwanted progeny. Translation. When irreligion is prominent in the family, O Krishna, the woman of the family become polluted, and from the degradation of womanhood, O descendant of Vrushni, comes unwanted progeny. Please repeat. When irreligion is prominent in the family, O Krishna, the woman of the family becomes polluted, and from the degradation of the womanhood, O descendant of Vrushni, comes unwanted progeny. Verse number 41. Sankaro narakayeva kulajnanam kulasyacha patanti pitaro hiyesham lupta pindodaka kriyah. Sankaro narakayeva kulajnanam kulasyacha patanti pitaro hiyesham lupta pindodaka kriyah. Sankaro narakaiva kulajnanam kulasya cha patanti pitaro hiyesham lupta pindodaka kriyah. Sankaro narakaiva kulajnanam kulasya cha patanti pitaro hiyesham lupta pindodaka kriyah. Whatever translation. Sankaraha, such unwanted children, narakaya, make for hellish life, eva, certainly. Kulajnanam, for those who are killers of the family. Kulasya, for the family. Cha, also. Patanti, fall down. Pitaraha, forefathers. He, certainly. Esham, of them. Lupta, starved. Pinda, of offerings of food. Udaka, and water. Kriyaha, performances. Translation. An increase of unwanted population certainly causes hellish life, both for the family and for those who destroy the family tradition. The ancestors of such corrupt families fall down because the performances for offering them food and water are entirely stopped. Repeat. An increase of unwanted population certainly causes hellish life, both for the family and for those who destroy family tradition. The ancestors of such corrupt families fall down because the performances for offering them food and water are entirely stopped. Verse number 42. Doshayaretai kulagnanam varna sankara karakaihi utsadyante jati dharma kula dharma cha sasvataha. Doshayaretai kulagnanam varna sankara karakaihi utsadyante jati dharma kula dharma cha sasvata. Dosayaretai kulajnanam varna sankara karakaihi utsadyante jati dharma kula dharma cha sanatana sasvata. Auto translation. Dosai, by such faults, yetai, all these, kulajnanam, of the destroyers of the family, Varna Sankara, of unwanted children, Karakaihi, which are causes, Utsadhyante, are devastated, Jati Dharma, community projects, Kula Dharma, family traditions, Cha, also, Sasvataha, eternal. Translation. by the evil deeds of those who destroy the family tradition and thus give rise to unwanted children. All kinds of community projects and family welfare activities are devastated. By the evil deeds of those who destroy the family tradition and thus give rise to unwanted children. All kinds of community projects and family welfare activities are devastated. Verse number 43. Utsanna kula dharmana manushyanam janardana narake niyatam vaso bhavati iti anushushruma. Utsanna kula dharmana manushyanam janardana narake niyatam vaso bhavati iti anushushruma. Utsanna kula dharmana manushyanam janardana narake niyatam vaso bhavati iti anushushruma. Utsanna, spoiled. Kula dharmana, of those who have the family traditions. Manushyanam, of such men. Janardana, O Krishna. Narake, in hell. Niyatam, always. Vasa, residence. Bhavati, it so becomes. Iti, thus. Anushushruma, I have heard by disciplic succession. Translation. O Krishna, maintained of the people, I have heard by disciplic succession that those whose family traditions are destroyed dwell always in hell. Please repeat. O Krishna, maintained of the people, I have heard by disciplic succession that those whose family traditions are destroyed dwell always in hell. Verse number 44. Aho bata mahat papam kartam vyavasita vayam yadrajya sukha lobhena hantum swajanam bujyatah. Aho bata mahat papam kartam vyavasita vayam yadrajya sukha lobhena hantum swajanam bujyatah. Aho bata mahat papam kartam vyavasita vayam yadrajya sukha lobhena hantum swajanam bujyatah. Aho, alas. But how strange it is, mahat, great, papam, sins, kartum, to perform, vyavasita, have decided, vayam, we, yet, because, rajya sukha lobhena, driven by greed for royal happiness, hantum, to kill, swajanam, kinsmen, udyata, trying. Translation. Alas, how strange it is that we are preparing to commit greatly sinful acts, driven by the desire to enjoy royal happiness. We are intent on killing our own kinsmen. Repeat. Alas, how strange it is that we are preparing to commit greatly sinful acts, driven by the desire to enjoy royal happiness. We are intent on killing our own kinsmen. Verse number 45. Yadi mama pratikaram asastram shastrapanaya dhartarashtrasya ranehanyo tanme kshemataram bhavet. Yadi mama pratikaram asastram shastrapanaya dhartarashtra ranehanyo tanme kshemataram bhavet. Yadi mama pratikaram asastram shastrapanaya dhartarashtrarane hanyo tanme kshema taram bhavet. What translation? Yadi, even if, ma, me, apratikaram, without being resistant, asastram, without being fully equipped, shastrapanaya, those with weapons in hand, dhartarashtra, the sons of dhritarashtra, rane on the battlefield, hanyo, may kill, that, me, for me, kshematram better, bhavet would be. Translation. Better for me if the sons of Dhritarashtra, weapons in hand, were to kill me unarmed and unresisting on the battlefield. Please repeat. Better for me if the sons of Dhritarashtra, weapons in hand, were to kill me unarmed and unresisting on the battlefield. Verse number 46, this is the last verse. This chapter. Sanjay Vacha Evam Mukva Arjuna Sankhe Rato Pastavupavishat विसृज्य ससरं चापं शोक संविघ्नमानसः। संजय उवाच एवं उक्त्वा अर्जुन संख्ये रथोपस्तमुपाविशत्। विसृज्य ससरं चापं शोक संविघ्नमानसः। संजय उवाच एवं उक्त्वा अर्जुन संख्ये रथोपस्तमुपाविशत्। विसृज्य ससरं चापं शोक संविघ्नमानसः। ओटो ट्रांसलेशन। संजय उवाच संजय सेड एवं दस उक्त्वा सेइंग अर्जुन अर्जुन सांख्ये इन द बैटल फील्ड रथा ऑफ द चैरियट उपस्थे ऑन द सीट उपाविशत सैट डाउन अगेन विसृज्य पुटिंग असाइड ससरम अलोंग विद एरोस चापम द बाउ शोक बाय लैमेंटेशन संविघ्न डिस्ट्रेस्ड मानस विद इन द माइंड। Translation. Sanjaya said, Arjuna, having thus spoken on the battlefield, cast aside his bow and arrows and sat down on the chariot, his mind overwhelmed with grief. Please repeat. Sanjaya said, Arjuna, having thus spoken on the battlefield, cast aside his bow and arrows and sat down on the chariot, his mind overwhelmed with grief. Important point it is ending with. Try to understand what Krishna is trying to tell here. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Mukam Karoti Vachalam Pangam Lankayate Yat Krupa Tamaham Vande Sri Gurum Devatarinam Paramananda Madhavam Sri Chaitanya Swam Harihi Om Tat Sat. We were joining. So here we are in the last section of this chapter, observing the armies. So interestingly, it is beginning and ending. You see the first beginning is Dharma Dhritarashtra Vacha, Dharma Kshetre Kuru Kshetre Samaveta Yutva Mamaka Pandavascheva Kim Akurvata Sanjay. That is establishing the Sanatana Dharma, Supreme Dharma, Bhagavad Dharma. So we can take in anyway, but in the highest level it is supreme dharma, especially Bhagavad Dharma, it is establishing. Now you see because this is still first chapter, okay? And if you look at the first chapter and what it is mentioning last few words from 39 to 46, you keep on mentioning about dharma only. But what level is not talking about the highest one? He's talking about kula dharma, jati dharma, kula jnanam, kula kshay. So in one way or the other, he is all bringing up jati dharma. So he is bringing up the subsidiary aspects of dharma. He is not bringing up the highest level of dharma. And that's why we'll see at the end of 18th chapter, then Krishna is mentioning that the sarva dharman parichyaja. All this throughout the chapters, you may see to some extent, but the highest that is the two main key verses of Bhagavad Gita, the codes. One is the sarva dharman parichyaja mam ekam saranam vraja aham tvam sarva papebhyo mokshayishyami maasuja. Then other one is manmanava mad bhakto madhyaji mam namaskuru. Okay, you want to surrender to me, that how are you going to surrender? What does it mean by surrender? At least practical sense, that's what he is giving, that second verse going with it. Manmanabha Madbhakta Madhyadimam Namaskuru Mami Vaisya Satyante Pridijane Priyosmi or Mami Vaisya Yuktaivam Atmanam Matpranam. In 9th chapter and 18th chapter, same verse is last two lines changes a little bit, but more or less same thing. Offer your obeisances, worship me, become my devotee. In this way, so Krishna is emphasizing that. So simple things, but it's not so easy. Unless we understand the Bhagavad Gita. So now Bhagavad Gita, that's how it starts. The first important point it is mentioning here is so the first verse, just discussing the last section of this first chapter. So the first verse of the chapter is begin with Dharma, establishing Sanatana Dharma, Bhagavad Dharma, and ending the last verses are talking about Kula Dharma, Jati Dharma, and all those. the secondary aspects, subsidiary aspects of the main dharma. So because Arjuna is, after seeing the army on the battlefield, his own family, he identified with his family as his immediate family. And he forgot his actual duty of a Kshatriya, and then immediately is giving his various reasons and doubts how not to do his duty. He wants to give up his duty and run away. So that is what is going on. But we will go in a little bit detail. The first section we discussed is the Bhagavad Dharma. How if somebody who is not performing Bhagavad Dharma, Sanatana Dharma, eternal Dharma of the soul, not just performing on the body level, then they will be gradually be elevated, eliminated, because as the unwanted things come up in the paddy field, then the unwanted things will be removed. Otherwise, the actual crops cannot grow. Same way, this Bhakti Lata Beej, the actual real consciousness, real spark of the soul, keep on identifying with the body. That's what is happening in this last sixth section of this chapter. Very much prominent, actually. It is establishing that why, that's why ending with the last line is also very important. Soka, samvigna manasa. Arjuna was overwhelmed with grief, lamentation. This is what we see in this material world. So then what is the remedy? What is the contraction to come out of this lamentation, constant lamentation? Regularly it happens, being in the material world, this is bound to happen. But then how do we come out of it? And that is the question we have to address. So question and answer has to be also given. And Srimad Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita gives the answer if you detailly study. So that's what is the first section. And the second section where it is mentioned in the further about how this leadership is misused by Duryodhana and party. In the second section, by mentioning various leaders, they want to take responsible position, but they want to take the authority, but they don't want to be perform responsibly. They don't want to follow the rules and regulations. They don't want to understand what is dharma of a highest dharma of a leader, protecting the citizens of the, not just simply to putting everything for their own enjoyment. So that is what is emphasizing, and many other things of. This is the first chapter is that more or less essence is the establishing how this material nature will be. What are the characteristics and properties of the material nature and what will be the result? If you associate too much absorbed with the material external manifestation of the Supreme Lord, neglecting the internal manifestation of the Supreme Lord, what will be the result? The result will be, as is mentioned first verse, so that's why we have to pay attention to the details and study detailedly, then only we can come to these conclusions. Even though it is clearly mentioned in simple terms, first verse and last verse, but we will not be able to understand that essence. First verse is mentioning that removing whoever is not going to perform the dharma by sitting in the leadership position like Dhritarashtra and Duryodhana, they will be wiped out. That means they are identifying with too much absorbed in the material aspects of it. That means they want Lakshmi, they want Lakshmi Devi, the property of Lakshmi. Who is the actual property of Lakshmi is belongs to Lord Narayan. Lakshmi Devi is never alone, she is always with Narayan. So that is, she is the internal energy of the Lord. But she has the other aspect which is the external energy of the Lord, which is the manifestation, the resources, the money, and whatever comes with it in this material world. That's all external manifestation of it. So if you utilize seeing, you can use it. Nothing is bad as long as we know where it is coming from. What is the real source of this money, this resources, whatever we got in this material world? Who is the actual source? Whom does it belong and how to utilize it? So in what context or what consciousness we should see it and utilize it? That is the important aspect. That's what is lacking in Dhritarashtra and Duryodhana. So that is the first problem, fundamental problem was raised in the first verse, in the last line of Dharma Kshetri Kuru Kshetri, or the first line. So that's what Prabhupada has in the purport detail explained. And that's what, because of their understanding, because of their absorption in the material world, external manifestation, not so much about the internal manifestation, they are not thinking about actual Lord Narayan, Lord Krishna, Lord Vishnu, who is the source of Lakshmi, who is the source of eternal energy, they are not able to understand that, then what will be the result? The result will be Sokamoha Bayapaha. So that's what is happening with Arjuna. Because Arjuna is not in that position actually, he is a pure devotee. But in order to really give the transcendental knowledge, Krishna is giving a chance to more than Arjuna to all others. They are also hearing. Battlefield, nobody is fighting at that time. 45 minutes more than around, between 30 minutes to 1 hour only this conversation happened. 700 plus verses on the battlefield of Kurukshetra, on the most complex situation. But Krishna is giving the chance to others to at least now, after hearing, at least change your consciousness, understand what exactly we are dealing with, where we are being so much absorbed, understand whom it belongs to, and try to perform dharma at least at some level, if not at the highest level, at least come to the ground at least to some level. If you are completely out of it, then nobody can help it. So Krishna is giving that chance, at least here, and if not you are at 18th chapter, you didn't get the essence, but at least you operate at least at some basic dharma. Don't be perform without any type of dharma. Then that's completely, it's going to be really dangerous. So that's what is happening in this first chapter. That is the setting. So that's what we have to understand. We have to make sure we understand these principles. As long as we are in this material world, whatever body we are going to get, depending on our actions in the next lives. So that's why future, in order for us to make a bright future, so we have to be careful in understanding these aspects from these examples of Dhritarashtra and Duryodhana. So that's why second section is leading on to this. We are all leaders, so how to be responsible and follow the direction of the Shastra and perform the dharma of that position of that leader, whether it's at home or at job or at community, wherever we are, controlling the country, whatever position we have taken, then we have to be responsible. So otherwise consequences, we may not see it directly, immediately, we will see the consequences for sure. We cannot go beyond the rules of the Shastra and the Supreme Lord. We cannot hide. We can hide from the law and order from these countries, but we cannot hide actually from the Supreme Lord. Karmana daivanetrena janto deha upavati. Supreme Lord, Super Soul, is watching as a bird in the heart of every living entity, not only human being but all living entities. But other living entities are not getting the actual any empire. They are gradually evolution. They are changing from aquatics to insects to reptiles to different animal species, birds and beasts. In this way, then human being at the last stage. And various grades of human beings are also there. So that is for them, it's a gradual evolution. There is no change. There is no sinful activity for them because they don't have a consciousness, fully conscious. They have consciousness, but they are in a minute level. Their intelligence is not so much highly elevated. They cannot understand things like we do. So that is why it is very important for human. So the second section is that, and third section gradually going on to the next level. How the senses must be controlled and use it in the Supreme Lord's Krishna and the internal energy of the Lord. Otherwise, our senses will be agitated, will not be able to have peace and happiness. So that is what is happening in the next section. Then only we can actually get victory. That's what is establishing. How Pandavas said they have so much victory in terms of the flag, in terms of the transcendental vibrations by the conscience, so many aspects, and the strategic positions, in so many different ways it is establishing. Only when you offer, you use your senses carefully in understanding this internal energy and use it, then automatically you will get victory in your material and spiritual. Both levels also we can get victory. Nothing is going to agitate us. In the beginning, there may be a little bit agitation here and there. Some disturbances will be there. Because that is a test. Because as we go through even in the material world, failures will come. That's what will make us strong and then go to the next step. So In the spiritual life also, we will go through that, because then only we will know that is a test, how much strong our faith is. Otherwise, so we will go back to our same thing what we used to do before. So that the faith must be strong, faith on especially the Supreme Lord, because Sadhu, Shastra, Guru, clearly, and we can see n number of examples in Shastra. So, yeah, so that is third section, and then the fourth section, it is continuing on in that way, after the how the Pandavas, following the Dharma, highest Dharma, they are able to get victory. Victory is being established automatically. Before actual war happened itself, it is mentioned. They are going to win the war. Sanjaya is telling indirectly. They are not, even Bhishma is telling indirectly. Even though just to satisfy Duryodhana, he blow the conch shell, but he is telling indirectly, you are not going to win the war. Why waste your time and my time? But he didn't understand. So he was very happy because Bhishma blew the conch shell. He was still thinking he is going to win. He didn't realize until the last day when he was done, when he was, his thighs were broken down by Bhima, and until that point he didn't realize. So you can imagine what kind of conditioning he is in. He didn't realize any of the days. So much was going on, but still. So that means how much covered up he is completely. Abodha Jata, it is mentioned. So that's what is mentioning. And then further, then the Arjuna is seeing the battlefield, and the Kurukshetra, and then he is immediately, first section is mentioning he went on as a devotee, as a Vaishnava, he is expressing compassion for all. So he exhibited those symptoms as a pure devotee, but at the same time then immediately he got changed into materialistic identification, the bodily identification. So that's what is happening in this section, specific section 5 and 6. So the Arjuna's lamentation, Arjuna's doubts, Arjuna's reason for not doing duty. He's telling, I don't want to fight because of compassion, no enjoyment. Compassion because of his own family, Swajanam. And then he doesn't want to perform the duty because of no enjoyment. If I am going to kill my own family, whom I am going to share the opulence with? Now in this specific verse, from verse number 39, it is mentioned about Kula Dharma, that is what first thing is mentioned here, Kula Kshaya and Kula Dharma, the family tradition, destruction of dynasty. Before that also, before we mentioned about the previous class is about the Papam, also is mentioned about the sinful activity. I am going to incur sin because of my killing, even though they are six kinds of aggressors. They have usurped my wealth, they have usurped my trying to kidnap my wife, burn my house. So all kinds of things, they try to do all the six kinds of things which Shastra says. At those times you can kill the enemy, you will not incur any sinful activity. But Arjuna is playing the role that is a saintly character. Then still my own family, it doesn't apply to me. So they still is going to incur sinful activity. Aga. So that we discussed at length, how to counteract the sinful activity. Sinful activity cannot be contracted by some material austerities, regular austerities. It is going to come back again. Temporarily, yes, we will be contracted for a few days or a few months. But the proclivities will be still there. The sinful activity proclivity in the heart is not going to be removed. So only way it can be removed is by engaging in the devotion service. So that is very important. It is like a forest fire. So things may get burned out, but after a few years, again things will start coming up, again sprouting, and then again plants will come. But in order for the whole thing to be destroyed within the heart, the unwanted things, then the only way is by performing pure devotion service. Gradually we will come to that pure state. But as we start, then gradually it will be removed in the heart. Unwanted things will be removed in the heart. So that's what is being mentioned. And the greed, intense greed, the material greed. Arjuna is mentioning the sinful activity and lobha upahata chetasa. That same similar point is also mentioned in one of the verses here also in this section. The greed, how to counteract the greed also. So greed can be there, but all the unwanted things can be utilized in Krishna service actually. That is a transformation. The same greed, yes, we can have a greed, but the slowly when it lies our senses in Krishna service, that material greed becomes spiritual greed. That means we will be greedy for serving Krishna, we will be greedy. Same money you may get, yes, you can get millions of dollars, but that same money can be utilized in Krishna service in so many different ways. So that way that material greed automatically will transform into spiritual greed. Then gradually you will be developing detachment internally within in the heart. So that is the beauty of this transcendence, engaging in bhakti yoga process. Now in this specific section it is mentioned kulakshaya kula dharma, destruction of the dynasty and family tradition, sanatana. But here the varnashrama system basically, so as we can see, kula dharma means each and every family has this varnashrama system. At least that time, still in, it is about Kali Yuga is about to begin. So even in the beginning of Kali Yuga there was varnashram. Now it's completely classless society. Nobody wants to, Brahmana, Kshatriya, there is no types of class. Everybody is acting like a, almost like a Sudra only. Kalau Sudra Sambhava. There is no samskaras, there is no impression. The samskaras means there is Shastra is clearly telling. And as soon as you are born, you are supposed to perform samskara like that. There are 10 dasavidha samskara. Then only the consciousness can be purified. We don't perform sacrifices, samskaras. Samskara means sacrifices, as per the scriptures. And Krishna is clearly mentioning in the 3rd chapter, Karma Yoga. As soon as living entity is born, in order for them to eat food grains, they must perform sacrifices. If they don't perform sacrifice, they will be implicated. Simple activity, that's where it is beginning. So that's why so sacrifices are important. Dasavidha samskara is important. Samskarat bhavet dvija. Those are some, only those who are performing samskara, dasavidha samskara, then they are called dvija, brahmanas, twice born. But in today's situation, Kali Yuga, nobody can claim that, really. That is the problem. So that's a varnashrama system means four varnas. That means the intelligent class, brahmanas, and then you have administrative class, kshatriyas, and then you have agriculture class, vaishyas, and then you have last class is servant class, sudras, and then there could be fifth and sixth class also. That fifth class means though are even lower than that. So and further than that is like chandalas and others. It is mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. Even but for them, any of this class, it doesn't matter. We will come to that. So here it is mentioned kula dharma means they are not able to even perform these, even the these family traditions. There somebody might be in especially kshatriya. Arjuna is in the kshatriya family. Both are Pandavas and Kauravas, and their family traditions, that means kshatriya tradition, might be destroyed because the actual leaders of the society is not there. Well, we can see also the same example in our family life also. Our grandfather, generally most of the cases, our grand, either maternal or parental, so one of them, at least some of them used to, if not great grandfathers, they used to perform some religious aspects, religious activities, spiritual activities, better than us now, better than our fathers, grandfathers and great grandfathers. But now we can see as the time passes by, they don't pick up those things, the younger generation, that means their sons and daughters, then what will happen? By the time second, third generation come, completely it takes, again they have to somehow or the other by the Ajnana Sukriti, by association of devotees or something, then only they can pick it up again. It takes many years, or it could take again many generations for them to pick up. So that's why if the actual person who is leading the spiritual activities, if they are killed, then the whole generations will be destroyed. The tradition, the actual dharma, jati dharma, the family project, community projects, the kula dharma, that means even within the community, like the Brahmana community, Kshatriya community, Vaishya community, they have performed certain things, charity, dharma shala, and feeding the poor people, and so many of these different type of dharmas, but this is not the highest dharma, but some kind of religious activities they perform in each of these ashrams. So, but that as soon as these people are killed on the battlefield, that's what Arjuna is claiming, they will be, then all these traditions will be destroyed. So that is what is mentioning Kulakshaya and Kuladharma. So not following the Varnashrama system. Ultimately, Varnashrama system is leading up to, as it is mentioned, Srimad Bhagavatam, Varnashrama Acharvata Purushayana Praman, Vishnu Aradhyate Nanyata Toshakarma. Idea of the point of ashram means, ultimately you are supposed to please Krishna, Lord Vishnu. That is what the sacrifice is also same thing. It is for pleasure of Lord Vishnu. Then only all the demigods get their share, and then only the living entity also gets purified. They are taking their share. That is the idea. So that's why it is very important that each ashrama means it must be revolving. The center is Lord Krishna, Lord Vishnu. Then only that is called samskara. That is called this varnashrama, ashrama system. That is grihastha, brahmachari, vanaprastha, sannyas, or the brahmana, kshatriya, vaisya, sudra. There's four classes of society. So now, but today completely it's different. So that's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given, because he is seeing the Kali Yuga, it's going to be very difficult. So that's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given for Kali Yuga. It doesn't matter what position, what varna, what ashrama, what caste, creed, where he is situated in this whole Brahmanda, doesn't matter. Jnane prayasam vatapasya namanti eva sanmukaritam bhavadiya vartam sthane stuti gatam sthane stuti gatam. Wherever you are, don't mind, oh, I am in the US, let me go to renounce this and go to India, because of this COVID or something or other, we may think, may give our own arguments, speculatively. But Shastra is clearly telling, for Kali Yuga, doesn't matter wherever you are. You just simply perform, sthane stuti gatam tanuvan manobhir, with body, mind, senses, just simply engage in the chanting of the holy name. So, Kirtanadeva Krishna Sangha Mukta Sangha Param Rajet. By simply chanting the holy name of the Lord, doesn't matter what position, what stage, what condition, you might have committed so many sinful activities, all those can be counteracted. Not by austerity, not by penances, not by other means. But in Kali Yuga especially, chanting of the holy name. So, that's what Shastra is mentioning. Namer akshara eito sobha vyavahita chadi vyavahita hailo na chade apani prabha. So the characteristics of the holy name, the essence, the especially the result of chanting the holy name, even if you inadvertently chant or incorrectly you chant the holy name, still the result will do its job. Holy name purifies the living entity. That's what. That means first of all you have to have faith. If you don't have faith and then you simply chant, let me get, maybe if I chant, I'm going to get a good job or I'm going to get millions of dollars or something, without having faith, then that may not be so good. Still, you are going to accumulate that bhakti ummaka sukruti, but we are not going to really purify, we are not going to advance so much because we don't have faith. That faith is very important. When it is mentioned, that Vyavahita means, Sri Bhakti Siddhanta Sattakur Goswami Prabhupada is explaining, that Vyavahita means, it is those who have faith in the holy name, faith in the Lord, then chanting, even if they, because like Westerners, Europeans, if you ask them to chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, sometimes because of their tongue, they cannot chant this mantra properly. Even then, still their effect is there. Because their consciousness has that, they want to chant, they want to glorify the Supreme Lord, they want to engage in His service, then automatically the result is coming, even though they may not be exactly chanting as per the scripture, the exact syllable. So, still the effect is there. So, like that, even somehow or the other, whatever way, as long as the consciousness, the faith is there, the result will be very much, it's going to purify the living entity, the soul. Then gradually, more he becomes more serious in that chanting, then automatically he gets pure. So that is what Kali Yuga, the power in Kali Yuga, the main Yuga Dharma for this age is chanting the holy name. So otherwise, all these various dharmas, Chala Dharma it is called. It is all secondary dharmas, Kula Dharma or Jati Dharma, Community Dharma, all this is going to be destroyed. It is like, so we know it, just like we all know, like, we were in India in the beginning, then we planned, so we don't know when we are a child, we don't know we are going to come to US, we don't know we are going to buy a car, we don't know we are going to buy a house, So many things we don't even know. But as we grow up, and then we may think, we at some point we desire, and then we come here. Then, but at some, that means, so we don't know what's going to happen. In the beginning, that these thoughts are not there. And for some time, this is, we may move into one house to another house. We may purchase another car. We may keep on changing things. So nothing is permanent. But we are thinking it's going to be permanent. But we can see in these thoughts keep on coming. We are accumulating things, and we are not satisfied, and we keep on going with things. But if you, whatever the situation is, if you think that whatever this is given by Krishna, okay, whatever activity I have done, so it is by the mercy of Krishna I am able to get all these things. Let me use, let me see everything in relation with Lord and use it in His service. Then that becomes more and more Krishna conscious, more and more it's going to help us not get on to lamentation, not get on to illusion, not get on to like Dhritarashtra and Duryodhana, the characteristics, so unwanted things in the heart will be removed. As long as we think and use it in consciously in relation with Krishna and use it in His service. So then automatically, the, as Achyuta, infallible Lord, as a Sarvopadi Vinirmuktam Tatparatmayam Ushikesh, Ushikesh is the controller of the senses. Supreme Lord will control our senses. Otherwise, it is not possible to control our senses. Because we are so minute, we cannot control our senses. We cannot control anything on our own. So only if Supreme Lord helps as a super soul, we will be able to control things. We'll be able to, otherwise we'll, our senses are always agitated. Our mind is also agitated. Thinking, feeling, willing, the acting. That is what mind's job is. Accepting and rejecting. Sankalpa and vikalpa. Constantly going on. Whether it's anything, even small things also, constantly, every day that is going on. So the, in order for that mind to be stabilized, even the senses to be controlled, then slowly and gradually we have to see everything in relation with Krishna and utilize in Krishna service. That is the Sanatana. We have to look for eternal things. So we keep on looking for some impermanent things. With whatever desire we have, from as we are progressing more and more, then constantly we are desiring. But if we can transform those material desires into spiritual desires, use it in Krishna's service, so then that is what is going to help. Otherwise, this Arjuna, just like Arjuna is giving his reasons to not fight, he is telling, I'm not going to fight because this is going to destroy family traditions. This is going to create Varna Sankara, because the woman may engage in irreligious activity, then unwanted population may come because they are not going to engage in sacrifice, they are not going to engage in this Dasavidha samskaras, and they are not going to engage in Krishna conscious activities either. Then it is going to destroy the whole family tradition, destruction of the dynasty, it is completely full of sinful activity, mahapapam. This is not ordinary sinful activity, but greatest sinful activity in destroying all this, and is giving, not only he is telling by his own example, people may say that it may be speculation, but he is telling Anusushruma, I have heard from a disciplic succession, I have heard from others in disciplic succession that those who are destroying the family, not only destroying himself and destroying the whole family tradition, dynasty and the whole this community projects and all these, then automatically you are going to dwell in hell for a long time for doing that activity. So not only that, he is telling that even the forefathers, because as soon as you stop this community projects, and what generally is supposed to be done is every year they engage in, they offer this Pinda and Udaka, Radha ceremonies, anniversaries, Samvatsrika, different names are there in each and every place. But it is ultimately, it is called Lupta Pindodaka. So Pinda means grains. Udaka means water. So this water and food is offered to Lord Vishnu. In Gaya especially, it is a very famous place. Lord Vishnu's lotus feet are there. So that when it is offered to Lord, it is the same as sacrifice. As soon as you offer to Lord, then automatically the forefathers get the benefit. Even if they are many times, they don't even have a actual gross body. Right now we have gross body. the covering. And then subtle body is mind, intelligence, is there, senses also, we cannot see. Some senses we are able to see, so that, but the mind, intelligence, we are not able to see. So that is the subtle body and false ego. Ego, real ego is transformed into false ego because of our material absorption. So that is called subtle body. So the when we offer the food, then these forefathers many times they may not have a gross body. They have a subtle body. Because of their sinful activity, they achieved a subtle body. Then that's why these things have to be offered every year. They perform these samvatsarika. There is a certain period in the calendar. 3 weeks or 1 month in a year. During that period, everybody offers for their forefathers. It's a standard 1 month is there like that. So during that period, everybody does that activity. So it ultimately, if they offer it for Lord Vishnu or feed devotees, Vaishnava Seva, then automatically they attain human birth at least. Then more and more they perform, then even elevated human birth. After some time, then they gradually get spiritual birth also, the spiritual body also. So that's why it is very important. But this is for those who are not Krishna conscious. This is for ordinary, those who are performing karma kanda, jnana kanda, for them this is recommended. For those who are Krishna conscious, they don't need to perform all this, the Shraddha ceremony and all. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu performed to establish as a leader, to establish dharma, dharma of the kama moksha. People may otherwise may not follow these rules, so that's why as a leader he established that. But otherwise, Shastra is clearly telling, Devarshi Nrunam, Bhutapta Nrunam, Nudhicha Rajan, Nayam Nudhicha Rajan, Kinkaro, Na Kinkaro, Nayam Nudhicha Rajan, Sarvatmana, Saranam Saranyam, Gato Mukundam, Parihapta Kartum. So it is mentioned Devarshi. As soon as living entity is born, we are indebted to so many of them. Deva means demigods, Rishis, sages, Devarshi, Bhutapta means friends, other living entities. Friends and relatives, Bhutapta, Runam, and kings, Nayam Runicha Rajam, Na Kinkaro, we will not be indebted to any of them. Na Kinkaro, Nayam Runicha Rajam, Runicha Rajam means kings, whoever is rulers in a specific country and place. Runicha Rajam, Saranam, Sarvatmana, who is the Sarvatmana? Is the Supreme Lord, Mukunda. Saranam, by taking shelter of the Supreme, those who are engaging and taking shelter of the Supreme Lord, Saranam Saranyam, by taking shelter of the Supreme Lord, Gato Mukundam, then automatically all our indebtedness will be removed. Parihurtya Kartam, everything is removed. So we don't incur any sinful activity, even if we don't perform. By engaging in devotion service, automatically we are going to get all the results of reading the Vedas, results of sacrifices, everything is attained by simply performing this devotion service. That is the result. So that is mentioned in the 8th chapter also. Bhagavad Krishna is mentioning in the 8th chapter clearly also. Vedesh, Igneshu, Daneshu, Tapasu, Cheva, Punya Phalam Pradishtam, Atyeti Sarvam, Vijitva, Sopayati Charjam. So, by simply performing devotion service, they will attain all the results of whatever karma kanda, jnana kanda, ashtanga yoga, whatever you name it, all the results of that. But not only that, you are going to attain the highest, dharma, ardha, kama, moksha, but even higher than that is Krishna prema, panchama purushartha. These are called chaturvedha purushartha, dharma, ardha, kama, moksha. People are interested in these. Ultimately, some point, they want to enjoy their life and they want to attain somehow liberation at the end. But they don't have a clear conception or idea of what liberation means, because they could merge onto Brahman Apalyan. That is one kind of liberation, Sayujya Mukti. But there are other four kinds of it. But we are not interested in any of that. We are interested in higher than that is Krishna Prema. Loving Supreme Lord Sri Krishna and in relation with Him, engage in His service, whether in Goloka Vrindavan or wherever He wants us to be. But we will be always in His service. Like whenever He comes, when Krishna came, so much Edu dynasty, almost millions of people. He expanded millions because He has brought all His associates from demigod planet and some from Vaikuntha, from spiritual world, Goloka Vrindavan also came. But many came from the different demigods also appeared. And then they have to be when Krishna left, they all got killed by his plan, because they have to go back to their own places and perform their duties. They went back. In that way, so Krishna always, those who are performing, then we can be in any planet performing during his pastimes, we might be engaging in his service. So, not necessarily Golok Vrindavan. So, wherever that service is, wherever he takes us back. So, that should be our, ultimately, the Pancham Purusharatha is attaining Krishna Prema in service of Krishna and his devotees. So, that is what is here, especially is mentioning. Arjuna is telling all these various reasons of destruction of dynasty and then your community projects, Kula Dharma, Jati Dharma, all these are mentioned. And then further, I have heard by discipline that we discussed. Last points, commit greatly, Mahat Papam, that we are going to come to it. Commit greatly sinful activity driven by the desire to enjoy royal happiness. We are intent on killing our own kinsmen. Then he is telling, better for me, apradikaram sastram. So, even if they come, apradikaram means I am not going to, generally we resist. This is the, even in the IT world, in wherever, whatever business, we resist for a change. We don't want to change. If somebody says, today also my boss got changed. They told he is moving in a different, this constantly this will happen. IT or business also, constantly this will happen. And through, we cannot, but we generally, because of the material absorption, immediately the mind will start creating an impression that, if this change, what is going to happen to me? So, what will that mean? So, I have to secure things and this and that. So many things will come into our mind because of the material absorption. That's what day in, day out, that's what we are in, so that it is very difficult. So here, but Arjuna is telling, apradikaram, so he is not resisting. Let it be so. If he come, I will not take up any weapons. Let them kill me. That is better for me actually. Let them kill me so that I am not, this is not going to incur sinful activity. Because I didn't take weapons and kill them. So they are killing me, so I will not incur sinful activity. I am not killing or destroying the dynasty. So they are doing. So it is better that let them kill me. So that's what he is saying. Apratikaram asastram. I don't want to take up weapons. This is what coming. Finally, he is mentioning Mahat Papam. Last verse is telling about this lamentation. How Arjuna, after saying all these secondary, subsidiary things of Dharma, is not talking about the real Dharma. He completely forgot about his Kshatriya Dharma is to protect the citizens. But he came to these secondary Dharmas. And then because of that, what is happening is soka, lamentation, udvigna manasa, not ordinary lamentation, fully agitated, his senses, mind, intelligence, everything got agitated, and then he couldn't even stand. He was so much enthusiastic before. Krishna, can you bring the chariot in between the armies? I want to see who and all are there, ready to fight. He took almost the arrows and ready to, he already shoot the arrows also. He offered his obeisances to Dhritarashtra, not Dhritarashtra, Dronacharya and Bhishma Pitama. Offered his obeisance, they also shot back. Congratulations, you are going to win the war. We are giving blessings. This is Dronacharya and Bhishma. Obviously, Duryodhana didn't understand that. So that is what is happening. Arjuna was in that condition, and then now we see immediately as soon as he was absorbed in the bodily concept. And then you can see the effects of that. Samvigna manasa, his mind, body, sense, everything got so much agitated. Then what is the remedy for it? So what is the remedy? Chastra is telling, first of all, why is in that condition? Is yaya sammohito jiva atmanam trigunatmakam. The main problem is he is identifying with the material modes. Mode of goodness, passion, especially ignorance. Same thing is mentioned in other places. Parabhavastavad abodha jata. The one who is thinking that I am great, I don't need knowledge. I am already learned. I don't want anybody, I don't want to learn from anybody. What is this Bhagavad Gita? What are these books? I don't need to learn. I already know. I am doing good. I am good buddy. So I don't need this. This is what people say. And most of the people, 99% or 95% in this world is in this category. So that's why it is called, Shastra is clearly saying, Parabhava, they are going to be defeated again and again. They are going to take so many species of life, they will be defeated because abodh jata. They are ignorantly thinking that they are expert, they are very learned, they don't want to listen from anyone. Especially sadhu and shastra and guru, they don't want to listen. Then automatically, pravavastavat abodh jata. Then karmatmakam sarira bandha. Immediately, after this life, next life, sarira bandha. Keep on getting these bodies. As long as they are in that condition, they are thinking they are the learned and they don't want to receive knowledge in transcendence, receive knowledge in disciplinary succession. They have to, Shastra is clearly giving that point, instruction, that there is no other way. They will have to take up the species of life, whatever. They may not even get human birth because of their activities in this current life. So that is the first point here. Eya sammohito jiva atmanam triguna atmakam. Actual Atma is the transcendental. It doesn't have actually material. Satchidananda vigraha. But because of absorption and identification with the these modes, identification with the external energy of the Lord, then he is caught up. Ya sammohita. Sammohita, illusion. So just like we are caught up. We don't know, in after 10 years, where I will be, where we will be, which house, which car, which job, we don't know. Now we are desiring for tomorrow or next year or something, but again, that these things will change and after 10 years we will be in something else. But we are still trying to get that permanent happiness through the temporary means. We are not foreseeing what is permanent. We are not foreseeing the hand of the Supreme Lord. We are not foreseeing the will of the Providence. So that is the problem with, because of this sammohita jiva. Because as Vyasadeva sat down in his meditation, then he is seeing how the living entities are contained. He is seeing the both internal energy and external energy. He is clearly seeing. Narada Muni has instructed him. Hey, what you have done? You have told everybody to guide them. Read this Vedas, Karma Kanda, perform Jnana Kanda, perform Ashtanga. So many ways you guided them. That's why you are not happy. You write the real thing. Don't divert them in so many different ways. You give too many options. And you didn't give it the real thing. What is ultimate happiness? Sukham atyantikam atendriyam. So, the sukham atyantikam means the unending supreme happiness. You didn't give that. So, it is above the ordinary blunt material senses. Atendriyam. Indriya, senses, sense happiness is, material happiness is temporary. But you are supposed to give atindriyam, that means above these blunt senses. So, please give that. Then he started meditating on that path given by Narada Muni. Then he could see the Supreme Lord, his internal manifestation. And he could see also external energy and see how external energy is, because of three modes, how the living entity is sammohita. He became illusioned. Completely caught up, thinking that as a permanent. So that is the first problem statement of Arjuna. Of all these reasons he is giving because of this sammohita, he became illusioned. He identified, absorbed so much. Bayam dhitiya abhinivesitasya. Immediately, because of identification, fear and lamentation, everything has come. Then what we have to do? Then what is the remedy for it? That also Vyasadeva is instructing. Vyasadeva is telling the remedy for it is this is anartha is the first of all problem is the further is telling the problem statement little give hints he is giving. Anartha upasamam sakshat bhakti yogam adokshati lokas ajanato vidvan chakre saktat samvidhan. So anartha, these are all because of anarthas. So that anarthas has to be removed. Upasamam, anartha upasamam sakshat. Directly you can. There is a medicine for removing these anarthas. Anartha upasamam saksha bhakti yogam adokshaje. The only remedy for it is engaging in the service of the Supreme Lord. Bhakti yogam adokshaje. Adokshaje means is above, beyond these material senses. Sometimes people think that when Lord comes as Krishna, Rama or Varaha, then he also like a material body. He also incur sinful activity and all. But he is beyond, he is like a sun in the material aspect, you can see. Teji yasana doshaya. He doesn't incur any sinful activity. So he will drain up everything, the smell and the whatever is there, all the dirtiness. Sun is destroying all those things. by his power. But son is not getting that sinful activity. Son is not getting that smell. Because that is the power of the son. So that prophylactic, acolytic, many different terminals there, words, technical words they use, what son is doing. So same way the Supreme Lord is, by Supreme Lord power only son is acting. Otherwise son is, doesn't even have power on its own. So you can imagine what is the power of the Supreme Lord. So Supreme Lord can never have a material thing when he appears, whatever form he is taking. And he never gets sinful activity. He never gets anything. He never gets conditioned. So whatever activity he does, there is no sinful activity on his on him. So the what we are discussing, anardha, anardha upasamam sakshat bhakti yogam adokshaji lokas ajanato vidvams. People are interested here, knowing only the ordinary material knowledge. Vidvams means material and spiritual. But here in this case, lokas ajanata means they don't know about this transcendental literature. Lokasya means general population, 95% of the people. Lokas ajanata means they don't have a knowledge of this spiritual subject matter, especially lokas ajanata vidam chakre satvata samhita. This is the satvata samhita, especially out of 18 Puranas, the topmost, the satvata samhita is Srimad Bhagavatam. That is what the medicine Vyasadev is mentioning. Chakre Satvata Samhita, by simply hearing and associating with this book Bhagavata and person Bhagavata, Srimad Bhagavatam, this is the topmost literature. So, by associating, what is it? Esyambai Sruyamanana, it is mentioned, Krishne Paramapurushe. So, Esyambai Sruyamanana, Krishne Paramapurushe. So, by simply hearing, Esyambai Sruyamanana, by simply hearing, Srimad Bhagavatam regularly, so among the association of devotees, then gradually, that means also Bhagavad Gita also, because Krishna spoke Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam is about Krishna and it is his own parts of the body from end to end, lotus feet to all the way to Mukut, lotus face is 10th canto or 12th canto is Mukut. So every part of the canto, the 17 books, 12 cantos are Lord's parts actually. Lord's own form, Srimad Bhagavatam, and Krishna is mentioning that first chapter, first canto, we see that last verse. Krishne Swadhamopagate Dharma Gnanadi Visa Kalau Nasta Drusamesa Purana Ko Dunodita. As soon as Krishna left this planet, before Kali Yuga started, after he finished his pastimes, he went back to his place. And so that time, where did all the Dharma, religion taken shelter? Krishna is mentioning that it has taken in the form of Srimad Bhagavatam. So by those, they can take, the living entities must take shelter of the Srimad Bhagavatam. We can offer tulsi leaves every day to Srimad Bhagavatam. It is not different from Supreme Lord, Sri Krishna. Like holy name is also called Nama Prabhu. It is mentioned, Rupa Goswami has written Namastaka. In that it is mentioned, it is compared with the holy name, like the tip of the toenails of the this lotus feet of this Nama Prabhu is compared by the like Upanishads are all glorifying the this lotus feet of the toenails of the lotus feet of this Nama Prabhu, Hari Nama Prabhu. So this is the first verse, Namastaka by Rupa Goswami, glorifying the holy name. You can imagine, just that's why when you touch the beads, it is like the tip, the touching the tulsi bead is the one of the gopis, one of the sakas. You can think in different ways. This is all, so that's why it is not ordinary thing. But it's a, so that's why the consciousness helps. Why we are chanting, with what consciousness we are chanting, it is all. So we should be absorbed in that. So those tulsi beads, tulsi, first of all, itself is a servant of Krishna. So she is always at the lotus feet of Krishna. She is always arranging pastimes for Krishna and Radha and Krishna and all others. She is always trying to give pleasure to Krishna, arranging so many things. So by touching, by in that mood of trying to get service through Tulsi Maharani, through pure devotee, Krishna service. So in that way, that mood we chant, we touch the tulsi bead, then it helps us to progress in right direction. And it also means they are the cowherd boys, it also means the gopis of Vrindavan, each bead in that way. So they are not ordinary beads, tulsi beads. So that's what 108 beads are 108 gopis. So So that is the concept here, that Nama Prabhu it is mentioning, Namastu. You can imagine the holy name power we are not able to understand, but it has supreme power. So he is mentioned Esyam Vai Swayamananam. The same way, so Srimad Bhagavatam is also, it is actually non-different from Krishna. Just like holy name is Nama Nama, Abhinnatvam Nama Naminam. So there is no difference between the holy name and the Supreme Lord. It is the impersonal form of the Supreme Lord, you can say. We are not able to see, but he can appear when we are completely spiritualized, purified. Then we can see the Lord, the holy name, the personality. Because in spiritual world, everything, there is a person behind. Actually, there is a person behind this. It is not just in material world, yes, it is like that. When you say water, we have to take water and drink it. When in spiritual, when you say water, you don't need to again go and get the water and drink. Our thirst is quenched. So that is, everything is spiritual. Here there is a relativity. It is not absolute. So that is what is the problem in this material world. So that's why here Sukadeva Goswami, especially Vyasadeva, is mentioning this. The remedy for this Soka Samvigna Manasa, what is Arjuna is in that condition, and we are all in this condition someday or the other. One day we might be happy, next day something happened in our family or in job or business, whatever. We might be going through so many situations. So somehow or the other we will be put into this, and then we will be in this Soka Samvigna Manasa. Then the result of that is we have to come out of that by Esyam Vai Swayam. Regularly we have to hear. So that's why hearing and reading regularly, personally and also in the association of devotees, as much as possible, we have to make that as a practice. Because it is not one day, once in a month I am going to read it, it is going to help me. No. Yeah, just like we are eating, just like we are sleeping, just like we are working, just like we are taking care of family, it is an everyday thing. We are not, one day we don't neglect any of this. So, same way, we have to also sharpen or purify our soul. We are doing for the body, but what are we doing for the soul? So, the soul also, soul is the one who is going to carry to the next life. Body is going to be finished. So, that is also even more important. At least the same importance we should give, try to give. And it's a gradual progress. So, in that way, we practice it. Abhyasa is very important. For material, just like we practice our coding, practice our job, so it's a practice. Then only we can improve things. We can become great leaders in job also. Same way for a spiritual subject also, it requires a great practice. Consistent practice. That's why there is a 9-to-5 in job. You have to be consistent in your presentation, consistent in your delivery of the goods, delivery of your work. Same way, we have to be consistent. If you want to progress spiritually, as material, we are thinking always, in job also, when can I learn new things or when can I get into the next level in our job. Same way, so we have to also see consistently, we have to focus on this aspect also. But as we give our time and that thought, that desire is there, then Krishna will help manifest it. So it is just first we have to have that sincere desire. I want to build upon this. I want to go further. I want to advance. I want to understand Krishna. Then Krishna will reciprocate always. One step, then he is putting 100 steps. Especially Purushottam month is giving. This is the special month of Supreme Lord Shri Krishna, Purushottam. That is why it is mentioned. Purushottam month name itself is Purushottam. So that is September 17th to October 16th. This is the most very, very auspicious. 1000 times, Damodar month is 100 times. Purushottam month, it comes only to every 2.5 years. Adhik Mas. For material things, it is not good. You cannot perform any material things, wedding or any other samskaras, they don't perform. But when it comes to the spiritual things, this is the highest benefit. Especially the more we chant, more we hear, more we read, more we engage in physical service, more we donate, anything in terms of Krishna conscious activities. So that gives tremendous result. Gives advancement very quickly. We can advance whenever we perform these activities, Janmashtami, Radhashtami, Gaur Purnima, Nityanam Trayodasi, Purushottam month, Damodar month. After the Purushottam month, the third month of Chaturmasa completes around November 1st week or so, then again, actual Damodar month starts September 17th to October 16th. That is in the middle of third month, it is stopping. Actually, this year it is a little bit interesting. And then from October 16th to I think October end or so, then third month will complete. Then the fourth month of Chaturmas is called Damodar month. That's when the actual, that is the next important month. Every year that comes, but Purushottam month doesn't come every year. It is every 2.5 years. So please take it up seriously. Any questions? I think we discussed that. That's the main point, is ultimately the medicine. Here it has been told, somehow or the other, take the association of Srimad Bhagavatam, regularly read, and most of you have it. So try to open Srimad Bhagavatam and read regularly, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, whatever time. You allocate certain time depending on your schedules. Gradually you can increase it step by step. And then also here, whenever we get opportunity. So that is the main medicine here to come out of this Arjuna's condition. It is just an example. Arjuna is being put into that condition. It is telling all of us, we are also in that position, then how do we come out of it? Regularly we are seeing that position, that situation within our life. Then how do we come out of it? So what is the constant practice, what do we need to do? So that is what Vyasadeva is telling us. Okay, we will stop here. Any questions?